Hello, welcome to my new video. Today I'm going to explain how you will integrate your Groovy script in MuleSB. So before that, we need to understand that what, why and how. So what is Groovy scripting language? It is an object oriented language based on Java platform. The 1.0 version released in January 2007, and the major version, and currently we're using a 2.4 version of Groovy script. Okay, it is a Java specification requirement is from MuleSoft side. It basically require a JSR, Java specification request 2 to 3, and those scripting language support this Java specification can be integrated with MuleSB. Okay, and why we need it? It's simple, because Groovy script solve our complex logic, custom logic. And there are some feature, we need to use those feature from Groovy, so that's why we need a Groovy script. And how we can integrate Groovy script in MuleSB? So it's very simple. We need a two dependency. One is a scripting module, as you can see that in screen. We need a one scripting module, the Mule scripting module plugin, and we need an engine. Okay, so guys, the Groovy engine not come default in MuleSB. We have to add engine as a Groovy engine using those dependency. Okay, so there's one engine, Nishon. Nishon engine is come by default, but here we need a Groovy engine. So this is the dependency in order to do a Groovy engine. Okay, that is clear. In my example, which I'm going to show you, this is the Groovy script I am going to use. And there is a special consideration on basically when you add dependency. So we also require a shared library. So I'm going to explain in a two way what normally we do and what we should need to do. Okay, and there are some engine name inconsistency troubleshooting also there. I'm going to explain that how you will solve. Okay, so let's get started with our demo. So I started my AnyPoint Studio. Let me create a new project here. New project, example Groovy-1. Okay, finish. Okay, new example is created. Let me create one listener configuration. Path, and let me so as you can see that I don't have any dependency, so let me add dependency. Either you can add manually the scripting module dependency here, or another way is to add searching in Exchange, like this way, searching in Exchange and searching for a scripting module. But I have already got dependency, so let me, and the dependency already downloaded in my m2 folder, so that's why I'm directly copying and added here in the pom.xml. okay, so I have added dependency. Okay, so once I have added the dependency, you are able to see that scripting module is coming, and we have a execute operation. Let me drag and drop it, this execute operation. Okay, so just guys, let's focus on this required library. It require a JSR 2 to 3 engine. So ideal way to configure from here. Okay, like add Maven dependency. Okay, so by default it is giving this option, this latest version of this Groovy script. So let me click on finish. So I have added like this way. I have configured and I have added. Let me show you what kind of change it done in the pom.xml. So as you can see that lastly I just add the Mule scripting module. I have click on JSR 2 to 3 engine and configure. I have click just configure, and I have add the Maven dependency in the pom.xml. It add this engine. Okay, and one more thing we need to focus on, that it is also add the library. What happened when we add manually this dependency, we forget to add this library, the shared library. So we will get an error. I'm going to show you what kind of error you are getting. Okay, so let me just configure happy path. So as you can see that the engine Groovy engine name is not showing, but let me configure my script, which is script I'm going to use. I'm going to use this script. Let me save this script in the, let me add here. So this is my script. I mentioned that. Okay, let me put one transform message. I'm going to convert this to JSON. JSON and payload PAYLOAD. Okay, so the main point is that we haven't choose engine here and the engine name is also not showing. Okay, but let me that's why we have a engine name inconsistency. So let me add directly that engine name here, GROVY, Groovy. Okay, so let me deploy this project. So meanwhile it is deploying, let me show you. So we need a scripting module and we need an engine because we are running Groovy, that's why we have a Groovy. And I configured there, that's why the shared library is automatically added. Most of time we forget to add the shared library. So let me explain what is a shared library. So basically the shared library help the application dependency. This is a kind of application dependency, right? This is a dependency we have added. This is application dependency. We are running Groovy. This is the application dependency. And this is the connector dependency. So connector dependency and application dependency want to communicate to each other. While this is scripting module running a Groovy script, it needs a Groovy engine. So how this connector dependency will get application dependency, that's why we have added the shared library. So what is the use of shared library? Let me explain that. When you need to make an application dependency visible to your application connector. So application dependency is Groovy engine and connector dependency is a scripting module, need to communicate to each other. That's why we need to add a Groovy. So my project is deployed. Let me hit on Postman. When I hit the Postman, I get the response. So let me make some changes. I'm not going to provide a shared library. Let me remove shared library. Okay, what will happen? What kind of error you're getting? So let me deploy because I have changed the form. Yes. So three things: scripting module, Groovy engine dependency, and the shared library. Let's see that what will happen. Yes, it says deployed, but let me hit. I have hit. So I've got error key that Groovy not found. Available is this, but Groovy is not found. This is kind of by default engine, but Groovy is not found. Why? Groovy is not found because of the shared library. So let me add shared library. Let me show you another troubleshooting. What happened? This name I normally added directly in the Groovy as an engine name, but what happened as per the MuleSoft documentation side, the studio configuration is this. So let me copy this name and add here and let me deploy your my project. Okay. So previously we have a engine Groovy, but now I'm kind of using a Groovy scripting engine. Let's see what will happen. I already add dependencies here. Shared library here, dependencies already adding. I have also added the shared library. Okay, so let's see that key whether this engine name works or not in current version of Anypon Studio or current version of Groovy scripting, Groovy runtime script dependency as we are using. Let me show you how it has looked like this. It looked like this Groovy scripting engine in XML. It is, yes, let me show you. It is Groovy scripting engine showing here like this. Let me send. Groovy scripting engine not found. Okay, so let me show you. And it is showing like this way. As an identifier, we have given a Groovy scripting engine as an identifier in the XML in the background. It is saved as like this. Okay, so let me check. It is running or not? It is running properly. Okay, but what is not running? So basically, you have to make sure that in XML, you have to make sure in the XML directly, you should have a Groovy in there. Suppose, for example, if you copy this in the XML, so it will not work because Groovy scripting engine is not a valid identifier in the XML. What is a valid identifier here in the GUI? It is a Groovy scripting engine, but in the XML it should be Groovy only. Okay, that only your scripting language is run. Let me change that. Let me paste and save. I'm not switching to UI. I'm just switching in the XML mode only. Okay. So let me show you what kind of error you're getting. So you're getting Groovy script engine is not found. What is found? Groovy only. Okay. So it is kind of inconsistent that key it is showing Groovy scripting engine here, but ultimately what is the engine name? The engine name is Groovy. Small G or capital G. No problem at all. We can provide both. Okay, but the engine name, we should know that key at in the front end side what it is look like, and in XML what it is look like. And the most important for troubleshooting, you may not able to see that particular engine or you will so that's why, because you just make sure that you provided a correct shared library, and in the XML you provided a correct name of the engine. So that is all about from my side. We will meet soon in our next video. Bye.